Hello, good morning students. Children, let us now revise our next chapter on plants, that is lesson number 7, Plants Living and Survive. As we discussed in the previous chapter, that plants prepare their food in the form of starch and they store that food in different parts of their plants, which gives them energy, which they helps them to grow. Even in the animal kingdom also survive due to these plants. They give us the food to eat, and also we get oxygen from the plants. Even the plants get carbon dioxide from us. So we are interdependent. Now in this chapter, as you know, we have already done this chapter. It's a revision that plants they survive in different areas in different forms, and that is called adaptation. It happens amongst the animals too. Animals as well as the plants, they grow and they, you know, they form in that way according to the environment they are in. As we discussed that the plants that grow in the hilly areas, they have very tall and straight. They are very tall and straight, and they have needle-like leaves. We discussed that they are usually tall and straight, and they have cones instead of fruit. They have those cones, you must have seen. They are flowerless, mostly they are flowerless, and they have cones with seeds inside them, and that is their help them to grow. Leaves of these plants are needle-like, and they have waxy coating to prevent the damage from the snow, like pine, deodar or fir tree that we discussed. These are the features of plants growing in the mountain areas or hilly areas. If you go to places like the Himalayan region, you will find these type of trees, or other parts of the world where it is very cold. Coming to the plants that grow in the desert area, they are totally different from the hilly area. Now because there is very less rainfall, so adaptation, because of this adaptation, they have very long roots. As I discussed in the previous, that they have long roots and that go deep under the ground to bring the water after, because they need water to prepare the food, and they don't have leaves. Leaves are absent, and they have spines. As you can see, this they have spines which help them to, you know, retain the water. Loss of water is less during transpiration. As I discussed, that while preparing the food, the plants give out water in the form of water vapor as well as oxygen. These type of trees, you find cactus. They have very thick and fleshy stem, which actually again store the water. Waxy layer they have, they store the water because water is less in the desert area. Next, if going to the next type of plants which grow in the areas where there is heavy rainfall, like damp and but hot weather. These plants have leaves that remain green almost all year round because they are known as evergreen forest children. These areas are very hot and damp. The temperature is quite high, but there is lot of rainfall, and they have different type of plants, trees growing in this region, like rubber tree, teak tree. You have, then you have sugar cane, pepper, rice, cotton. Different type of trees grow, and they shed their leaves in different time of the year, so they remain green throughout the year. So they are evergreen. Almost every time you see thick forest over there, and because of heavy rainfall, rain is very important, means water is important, as well as high temperature. Coming to the next one is the places where there is a swampy area. Swampy areas means children, where it's a marshy area where there is water logging, which we discussed. Plants here are very, because the soil is sticky and clay, and this is called marshy or swampy areas. It becomes very difficult for the plants to grow because they remain waterlogging every time, and that's why it's a unique type of plants you see here, which we discussed that they have breathing roots. The roots come out of the soil for the taking the air to breathe in. So that's a unique type, and you can find this the mangrove forest. They are called mangrove forest in the swampy areas, and Sundari trees grow in this area, and they have mangrove forest breathing roots, as you can see. So children, there are different type of trees as you can see, and then the next one, children, the plants that grow in the plain lands, like we live, they have several branches. They can survive in hot climate and they shed their leaves in the month before, you know, dry season. They shed their leaves, and mango, sisam, peepal, banyan trees, you find Gulmohar. So as you can see children, these these plants, they grow in different region, so they are called terrestrial plants. Plants that grow in the mountain region, plain region, desert region, or maybe hot and humid region, or the marshy region. They are all called the terrestrial plants because they grow on the land area. Next, we studied about the plants that grow in water, isn't it, children? The plants that grow in water, they are called aquatic plants. Aquatic plants means plant growing in water. This they have fixed plants, underwater plants, and we have the next one is called the floating plants. Okay, I'll just show you floating plants. These are floating plants. So different type of aquatic plants which we discussed, children, that types of plants or water plants grow in water and their stem stays under the water. Some water plants have very big floating leaves. Plants like hydrilla grows completely under the water. So these are lotus, duckweed, hydrilla, you have seen. We have discussed about this. Now coming to the three types of aquatic plants. First is the floating plants. They are light, spongy, and float on the surface of the water. By the name you can understand, floating. They float in the on the water, the surface, and their leaves are very light and they are very spongy, which store water. So you have this type of duckweed and water. Then children, coming to the next one is our fixed plants. They have fixed roots to the and their roots are fixed to the bottom of the plant, okay, which you see the water lily or lotus plant have hollow stems to reach the surface of the water, and they have broad and waxy coated leaves to prevent them from rotting. Rotting means spoiling because they remain in water all the time. And the third type of aquatic plant which we discuss is underwater. They are completely under the water. They have narrow leaves without any stomata. They don't have stomata. Their breathing and all these things are done on by the surface and keep the water clean. And actually in the aquarium you find this type of underwater plants like tape grass and pondweed. And these are the different type of terrestrial and aquatic plants which we discuss. Thank you.